everybody, and welcome to another amazing tutorial. My name is Dawn, and I am the oracle behind this crime-fighting team that is nerdygirlcreative.com. Nerdy Girl Creative is a site where you can create, learn, and share graphic design ideas and projects, as well as get awesome design assets and a lot of freebies. This week, I'm going to be working in Photoshop, and I'm going to show you guys how to create your very own greeting card mock-up. Just from a regular image, I found this image over here at unsplash.com, and if you guys follow me at all, you'll notice that I use a lot of images from unsplash.com, and that is because they are commercial free and you can use them for pretty much any project that you want. So let's go ahead and jump right in and get started. So I'm going to come up here, I'm going to open the image, and there we go. And as you can see, the image is pretty plain. She's got a nice picture of this latte here and the greeting card that we're going to be working with. So the first thing that we're going to want to do is I'm going to just go ahead and create a copy of my background. It's just sort of a good idea to do as a rule of thumb, just so that you have a copy that you can start working on and you're not, you know, messing around on the actual background image. So a quick shortcut to make a copy is going to be Command or Control J on the keyboard. Okay, and we're going to go ahead and zoom in, which is going to be Command plus or Control plus on your PC. And we're going to get kind of close in here. And as you can notice on this greeting card, there's actually something kind of already pressed into it. So we want to sort of get rid of that so it doesn't show through any of the image that we're going to be using. And a good way to quickly cover something up that you want to stay hidden is to hit S on your keyboard, which is going to bring up your clone stamp tool. You're going to notice you can make the brush bigger and smaller by using your open and close bracket key. And I'm going to go ahead and choose an area to start working with. And when I hold Alt, you can see this tiny little bullseye, and it's going to show you the area that you're going to be picking up to clone. So I'm going to go ahead and click right here, and then you're just going to kind of start to cover things up. All right, and there we have it. So now we've roughly covered up the area that we don't want to be seen through our image. And I'm gonna go ahead and just come over here, and my colors are gonna be, I need the white color, and I'm going to create a rectangle. So I'm gonna go ahead and choose the rectangle tool. I'm gonna move up here, and I'm just gonna go ahead and create a rough rectangle. It doesn't need to be super perfect at this point because you're just going to, you know, move and distort it later, or in a second actually. So we're gonna go ahead and the first rule of thumb when you're going to be creating a mock-up is to anytime the object that you're going to be using to project your artwork onto, it needs to be created into a smart object before you start to do any moving around or distorting or anything like that. So make sure that you always start that first. That's the first step. otherwise, if you kind of mess something up, you can't go back and fix it. So we're going to go ahead and right click it. We're going to just convert to smart object, and I'm going to hit Command T on my keyboard or Control T on your PC, which is going to bring up the transform. Then I'm going to right click and go ahead and hit distort. So as you can see, distort, you're able to move these little handles around and move them where you want them. So what I want to do first, though, is to bring down the opacity on my rectangle so I can see the card behind it that I'm working on. And I'm going to go ahead and start placing the points of my rectangle to cover up the areas of the card. Okay, and once you have your points pretty much where you'd like them, I'm going to go ahead and hit OK on the keyboard. And so right now it doesn't really look like we did a whole lot, but we'll go ahead and bring the opacity back up. And as you can see, now I just have sort of a white triangle sitting on top of the card. All right, and this is where the magic of the smart object comes into play. So now that we've created this smart object, we can now put whatever kind of artwork that we want on here. And for this, I'm going to go ahead and use some hand lettering that I have done. If you guys check me over on Instagram at Nerdy Girl Creative, you'll notice that I do a lot of hand lettering as well. So this happens to be one of the, you know, things that I've done a little bit work on. And so what we want to do is we're going to come over here and we're going to double click on our smart object. And as you notice, it brings up this rectangle, and that is the exact same dimensions of the rectangle that we just created. So we can put anything on here, and it's going to, we're going to save it, and then it's going to go ahead and be placed on the rectangle that we put over in the other image. So what I'm going to do is come over here and grab my butt first coffee and bring it on over into here. All right, so when we created the rectangle, you notice it's this way. Ooh, move that. You notice it's long ways. Well, our card is kind of tipped to the side, so we're going to have to tip our lettering to the side as well. So I'm going to go ahead and just Command T. All right, and I'm going to hit OK. Now, if you notice, I'm going to go ahead and just go ahead and Command S at this point, which is going to save. And then we're going to come over here and we're going to see, boom, there it is, right on our thing. And if you just had lettering, you could kind of be almost done. We do have one more step with the blending tools or the blending option, but we're going to jazz it up a little bit more, you know, make it, you know, look better than just a plain, you know, but first coffee, even though that's pretty true. I'm going to go ahead and place a couple coffee stains on here and, you know, make it look a little bit more nice. All right, now that I have got my coffee stain, I'm going to go ahead and size it up. And then I'm going to go ahead and make a copy of it, which is, again, Command J. And then I'm going to Control T. I'm going to size this one down just a tad, and then I'm going to rotate it around just so we can kind of get a nice sort of frame for our butt first coffee, sort of like you had your cup sitting on top of it. All right. And then I'm going to come over here and I'm going to pull in these splatters that I have. These are watercolor splatters that I made for my soft watercolor pack. And this one happens to be splatter number 4. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and just grab this and drag it into my rectangle here. And I'm going to Control T, come out just a bit, scale it down, rotate it around. I kind of like it right there. I'm going to go ahead and hit OK. And I want this to sit underneath my text, so I'm just going to bring it down here underneath on the layer. I am going to change the hue to sort of a, that's too green, kind of around this sort of color. And then I'm going to bring down its opacity. All right. Then I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to make another copy, Command J. And I'm going to Command T to transform. And then I'm just going to rotate this around until I get another sort of splatter area that I like. And I can kind of bring down the opacity on that one just to fade it a bit more too. All right, and instead of having just this plain white background, I'm actually going to kind of come in here and sort of find a nice kind of cream color. All right, so find a nice sort of light cream color, which that one looks pretty good. And I'm going to go ahead and Command S to save. And I can go ahead and close. So this is really good for showcasing any kind of typography that you have, any kind of, you know, card designs that you've come up with. It's really quick and easy to make a mock-up so that, you know, you give it a sort of interesting look and you can kind of show your clients or even your friends, you know, what your design's going to be. So here is the magic, and there we go. Now our card is pretty much done. But to sort of make a little, you know, some things a little bit more interesting, I don't particularly care for the, you know, I think this photo is very pretty, but I think it could be cropped in a better way. There's a lot of table going on here. And if you were sort of you know, creating a scene, you could put some more stuff in here, which if you notice in my other one here, I did put some more objects in here. You know, I got a phone and some headphones and some, you know, little clips and stuff just to put more objects in the scene instead of just having a pen and a, you know, a greeting card and a cup of coffee. So we can go over here and get our crop tool. And I just want to sort of tighten things up just a little bit. We still have some space to, you know, add some things in if we want, but I think that this gives it a little bit better showcasing of what it can really do. So the very last thing that we're going to do is we're going to change the blend mode on our rectangle so that it will blend in more naturally with the, you know, the lighting that's going on in here, because it's going to be showing the actual card in the background through. And that's why we got rid of, you know, what was showing in the background, even though it was very minor and probably wouldn't have made that big of a difference. You know, you never know. It's sometimes those small things that kind of distract you. So what we're going to do is come up here, and we're going to come up here, and we're going to change our blend mode to multiply. And then as you can see, it kind of just gives it, it blends more into the scene and is not super stark white right against it, or even, you know, stark cream that we had, but it sort of takes on, you know, the rest of the lighting around the area. And that's pretty much it for this tutorial. So I showed you how to create a really simple and easy mock-up, and you can use this to, you know, put up mock-ups for your invitations, your greeting cards, you know, showcase your typography, your drawings, absolutely everything that you guys are super creative with and make. And then, you know, if you have some other things, like I happen to have a few things for creating more scenes, you can add all kinds of different elements. You can put a little bit of, you know, a couple filters in here, maybe change the coloring up a little bit. But, you know, they're really quick and easy, and they're, you know, they go a long way into making, you know, your artwork shine through. So, all right, guys, I hope everybody liked this tutorial. We learned how to create this mock-up, and don't forget to like, subscribe, and share these videos. I create a new freebie or tutorial every week. And if you have any suggestions as to what you guys would like to see next, don't, you know, feel free to leave comments in the section below. And don't forget to head over to nerdygirlcreative.com, where you can grab, you know, more design assets and some freebies. There's always freebies. Freebies are fun. And I'm going to go ahead and leave all the assets in the description below for you guys to check out. And be awesome and create something amazing.